Good morning, guys. And I'm Gemma. And we're going to talk today about mindfulness and the concept of aversion. So, aversion is one of those feelings, sensations, things when something comes up and we don't like it, we don't want to feel it, so we just shove it right down there. This can happen with a lot of things in life. Sometimes we don't like the way certain people or things or ideas or concepts make us feel. Sometimes people say things that hurts our feelings. And we don't like the way that that discomfort sits in our body. So rather than acknowledging it, we just push it down and we avert from it. It's like when you look away from something that you don't like, you avert your eyes. It's the same thing and the same concept is rather than noticing and processing and dealing with an issue, we just try it, we go on autopilot and don't even acknowledge it. Sometimes this can lead to abusive situations happening. Sometimes this can lead to us not living in alignment with our own belief system. Sometimes it can happen because of trauma and past experiences. Sometimes it just happens because it happens, and aversion's gonna happen because who really likes to feel uncomfortable? I know I don't. And sometimes when that discomfort shows up, it can look different for everyone. So I want you guys to think of some instances in which you have averted from your feelings or from a situation because it made you uncomfortable and you didn't want to deal with it. And if you have any examples, I want you to think of them and think of what happens to you when you avert from your emotions or things that are happening, and does that make them really go away? For me, what I've noticed is that just because I avert from something or I don't want to notice it, it doesn't mean that it goes away. It doesn't mean, if someone's here and I don't like them and I just turn my back on them, it doesn't mean that they're not here. They're still here. And I still have to find a way to deal with it. It's the same thing with those emotions. Just because I don't want to look at them or I don't want to look at those things, it doesn't mean they're not there. Have you ever put a cap on a soda bottle and then shaken it up? So if you do that, and I'm not going to do that example simply because I don't want to get everything dirty over here. But if you do that and then you open it up, it explodes everywhere. So that's kind of what happens when you avert from your feelings. It doesn't mean that they go away. It just means that you're putting a cap on it. And eventually later, other situations can arise and they can remove that cap without you wanting them to. And all of a sudden, you can explode with emotions like sadness or anger, or you can just continue averting, and sometimes that can cause depression or anxiety feelings that happen, because when we don't acknowledge our feelings or the issues that are happening, it doesn't make them go away. So what we want to do, similar to what we do in the meditation, is we want to notice what we're experiencing, and we want to come back to the present moment, and we want to notice what we're experiencing, and we want to come back to the present moment. This way we are honoring ourselves and acknowledging the many and varied emotions or discomforts that we can go through, and then simply being able to come back to the present moment, noticing that perhaps those emotions aren't in the here and now. Perhaps those emotions don't need to consume or control us, but perhaps they are emotions that we should begin to feel or process with others. Perhaps they are something that we need to start having a voice about, or perhaps they are something that we can start talking to our parents or our professional or someone about, so that we can get these feelings or emotions out of us so that we don't have to live on autopilot anymore. I know that for me, I don't like living averting from my emotions. I don't like discomfort. And I've been through a lot of things in my life that were very uncomfortable. But by avoiding them, it didn't make them go away. They just came out years later. And years later, when I decided to feel these emotions, they were all still right there. And I had to start processing them slowly and recognize that I didn't have to react because of them, but it was okay for me to acknowledge that they were there. So today what we're going to do is we are going to start noticing aversion and things that we don't like and how they make us feel in the body. And we're going to do this with an exercise on mindfulness. So we are going to begin our meditation. And I'm going to warn you, advise you, that I'm going to be making many varied and different noises in the background. Some of these noises may sound intrusive. Some of these noises may sound loud and obnoxious. Some of these noises may bother you or give you chilling sensations or get your heart rate going, or some of these noises you might even like. Just notice whatever shows up for you as I am making noise in the background of our meditational practice. I will still be guiding you in the practice today of noticing what you're noticing, but we're going to take some time to build up to noticing discomfort and noticing when we want to avert. Here's a really good example, because I am very good at doing this. When I used to live with my mother used to yell my name while I was watching TV. And she would say, Jenna, 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 Jenna. I didn't hear her. I was so into the TV show or so into whatever I was doing or so into whatever I was doing on my phone. And she would say, I called you 10 times, like, did you not hear me? And the fact is, I averted from that because I knew she was going to ask me to do something that I didn't really want to do. And my brain created this reaction where I just ignored my mother. I averted from the sound of her voice. I had no idea that she was talking to me. And sometimes that happens. When we avert from things, we can sometimes go on autopilot and have automatic responses of like, yeah, yeah, whatever, because we just don't want to acknowledge or deal with these things. Or we say things like, it's okay, or we say things like, I'm sorry, when we're not really sorry, in order to get out of these uncomfortable situations. But noticing the discomfort and noticing the desire to avert from certain things like conflict or sounds, this is going to help us figure out what our belief system is and what are things that we want to handle and things that we don't want to handle, and having that ability to choose what we want to do next with whatever we discover about ourselves. So I'm going to ask that everyone be seated in a nice and comfortable position. So we're just going to sit back comfortably. And whenever you're ready, take a deep breath in, remembering that the intention for this practice is to notice what you're noticing with the varying sounds that are going to be happening in the background. I'm getting into this comfortable position and preparing to hear the sound of the bell to begin our meditational practice for today. Simply noticing the initial sounds in our body and how they make us feel. Noticing any judgment, noticing the breath, and noticing how with whatever sounds occur around us, we can come right back to the breath and the body to center ourselves. Feeling the sensation of the natural breath, noticing perhaps the temperature in the area around you. Noticing perhaps the fabric of the clothes on your body. Noticing how your body is feeling at this very moment. Noticing perhaps restlessness show up or anticipation. And simply feeling into it and coming back to the breath. Noticing any sounds in the background, any rustling, and simply noticing the breath and the body, and noticing how we're feeling about certain sounds. Are happening. Noticing any judgments, noticing any discomfort and where it might be in the body. Noticing what happens as the sound slowly stops. Noticing what happened to the heart rate, to the thoughts. Noticing if we're able to come back to the breath and the body. Noticing any aversion or discomfort or desires to tune out. And rather than judging or averting, simply noticing. Coming back to the breath and the body. Noticing the expansion and contraction of the breath. And noticing, again, what happens as we invite a new sound into the area around us. Noticing what happens with every thud. Get attached to a certain rhythm. Noticing if we're still able to connect with the breath. Noticing what happens to our heart rate. Simply noticing what's showing up in your practice today. Noticing the body sensations that come with each sound. Are they the same or are they different? Noticing the judgments. Noticing the restlessness. And noticing the breath in the body. Noticing that perhaps, even though there's so many different sounds, that perhaps we can still stay centered. Or perhaps notice that we can't. Desire to perhaps react or avert. Noticing what these sounds bring up for us. Noticing any anticipation of another sound. Noticing again the breath and the body. Noticing perhaps the desire to open our eyes as certain sounds are being made. Noticing all of the body sensations that are taking place. Noticing the next sound and what it brings up for us. Desire to avert or tune out. Perhaps noticing that this meditational practice was very aggravating noticing those emotions that are happening, noticing those body sensations, noticing those feelings, those sounds, the things that are happening that you want to turn away from, that you want to turn off. And rather than turning them off, noticing how they are making you feel and acknowledging them for what they are. Just sounds, just thoughts, just things that are happening. Noticing that you have the ability to lean in or to lean out. But always that you have the ability to acknowledge what's happening and make a choice. The choice is always yours on a daily basis if you just start to notice what you're noticing. Awareness is half the battle, and it is a beautiful, beautiful journey in noticing and learning more about yourself, the world around you, and the things that make you you, the things that you enjoy and you like, or the things that you don't like and you avert from. Noticing when your body has a desire to go on autopilot and tune things out, or when you have a desire to lean in. The more you decide on a daily basis to practice mindfulness and to embrace whatever shows up in your practice, the more you get to know a little bit about you. And that is the only goal. Every single practice is to simply noticing what you're noticing. So, as we begin to end our practice for today and our exercise, preparing to receive the sound of the bell to end our meditational practice. Wiggling our fingers and toes. Slowly opening our eyes and coming back into the room. Simply noticing what you're noticing. Today was a really good practice and I hope you guys enjoyed it. I definitely learned what sounds I want to avert from and what sounds actually didn't bother me as much as I thought they would. So, for today, I hope you got to learn a little bit more about yourself. Today, allow yourself to be a little bit more open to the things that you want to avert from and go on autopilot with. And maybe, just for a moment, rather than averting, leaning in and simply noticing what happens when you do. I'll see you guys again soon. I hope you have a great day.